ॐ वक्रतुण्डमहाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा। सरस्वति नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा। साक्षात्कृतं दयानन्दं परमार्थस्वरूपिणं तत्त्वज्ञानप्रशास्तारं प्रणतोऽस्मि परं पदम्। वागर्थाविव सम्पृक्तौ वागर्थप्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरौ वन्दे पार्वतीपरमेश्वरौ। एनाक्षरसमाम्नायम् अधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृत्स्नं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनये नमः। वाग्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारञ्च प्रणतोऽस्मि मुनित्रयम्। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तशान्तशान्तिः। Chanting of shabdas we will do next class. We have done. Now I will introduce some new shabda. Next class we will continue with the topic of sandhi. So what was the last topic we saw in the sandhi?
Visarga sandhi.
Visarga sandhi. Under visarga sandhi, what?
Looking at the rules, the exceptions. Definitely.
Visarga preceded by a.
Exactly, that is what, yes. Preceded by a, followed by a, preceded by a, followed by ash. All those things we are seeing. Okay. Now let me ask. You can answer. How this Visarga? Visarga is born. Katam visargasya jananam bhavati.
The padanta sakara.
Padanta sakara. Padanta sakara becomes ru. Ru is nothing but repa.
Yes.
That is one thing.
When followed by
karasana?
Not followed by kar. Padanta Sana. Repa. Only we are talking about only. Okay, we're talking about okay, Visarga Jananam. Yes. Yeah, sorry. Yeah. Then the Repa is at the Avasana or followed by Kar letter becomes Visarga. Yes. So you need to understand there are two types of Repa. One is the Repa which is born of Ru. Other one is Repa other than Ru. Other than Ru. That Ru, when does it happen? Padanta Sakara becomes Ru. Okay, all these things we have seen, just you have to recall. Why this is required, Ru and Repa, only what in the Repa? Everything is Repa only. No, there is a difference. There is a difference that is in the beginning itself, if you keep on stressing that. So later when a different rule comes, you understand what this Repa is. Is it a Repa born of Ru or is a Repa other than the Ru Repa? What are the other than Ru Repa? There are Avyaya Repas are there. When you say Antar, Pratar, punar repa of those avyaya. They are not born of room. So that repa is different. Bhinna repa. They are different repa. So padantasakara becomes room. That is how I started, because I just wanted to show you the birth of repa, and from repa, visarga is born. Okay, good. So padanta sakara become ru, and ru is nothing but repa, and repa the avasana followed by kar will become visarga, and followed by kar letter. 13 kar letters are there. Depending on what kar letter follows, that visarga was further undergoes changes. That we saw. Then that visarga again undergoes changes when followed by kar. What will happen to the visarga when followed by kar letter?
Three categories.
Three categories, okay. Visarga followed by ka, kha, or pa, pa. Visarga will be optionally replaced by ardha visarga. That is one category. If it is followed by the sibilance, sha, sha, sa, ti, the sibilant, kar letters, what will happen to visarga?
Cha, cha becomes shakara.
No, visarga followed by shakara, shakara, sakara, masculine.
Optional, Guruji.
Optional, that is good. Replacement of visarga by sakara is optional. That is what you have to say. Replacement of visarga by sakara is optional. And then, if sakara replaces, then you can do stutva sandhi. Or stutva sandhi, whatever may be. Then that is one category, I said. Other categories other than these two, that is cha, cha, and tha, and this tatha. These are the another six letters. When this kar letter follows, the visarga will be replaced by
sakara.
Sakara, and then stutva sandhi, astutva sandhi will happen accordingly. All these things should be very clear. Okay. So these are the changes happen. Now this change is happening to the visarga we saw when kar letter follows. Now, what will happen when other than kar letter, that is kar is hard consonants, other than kar is soft consonants and the vowels. Vowels and soft consonants. What will happen? That is what the topic we are seeing it, looking at. Okay. That we saw in the last class, visarga followed by ash. So, vowels and soft consonants together, they are denoted or presented by the pratyahara ash. Ayuvun, ruluk, evong, ai, auj, hayavarat, lang, nyamanga, nanam, jabhai, ghadhadash, jabhagadhadash, up to that. So, ach plus hash, vowels and soft consonants. So, when visarga is followed by other than kar letters, that is ash letter, what will happen to visarga? That is the topic we are seeing. So, when followed by ash letter, then you have to see what precedes visarga. The preceding letter becomes important. When kar letter follows, preceding letter not important. When the succeeding letter is kar, then the preceding letter is not important. Whatever may be the letter precedes visarga, that doesn't matter. Whereas, when visarga is followed by ash letter, then the preceding letter to visarga matters. Therefore, that we have to consider what letter precedes that we have to see. So, that is what we saw. Visarga preceded by akara, short vowel a, followed by a. This is one category, important. Then in that case, the visarga becomes u. That I explained very clear in the last class. I don't want to repeat again. You have to recall. Okay. Visarga means that it is repa. You have to understand it as repa. Repa is replaced by. Repa means what? Repa is actually ru. the repa born of ru, that is what is there, repa. You have to recall from the last class. That is replaced by u, that is one, number a. Second one, visarga preceded by a, followed by soft consonant. In that case also, the visarga, visarga when I say, you have to know that it is repa. Repa which is born of ru, or any repa in fact. A repa in general, you can take repa in general, not any repa, because any repa is that becomes a problem. So repa which is born of the visarga here, so therefore room repa, that also becomes replaced by ukara. Then visarga preceded by a, the third one, see, followed by h. When I say followed by h, h covers a. And that category already covered. Therefore, excepting a, akara, all the other letters, starting from a and onwards. What will happen to the visarga? Visarga means, note here, it is repa, which will be replaced by yakara. Then you have to connect with the achandi we have seen. If it is padanta yakara or vakara, remember, padanta yakara vakara, preceded by avarna, followed by ash letter, yakarasya lopaha bhavati optionally. Understand? Do you remember? Atsandhi, which we dealt with elaborately. A special optional rule that you have to connect to that rule. You have to connect this. If the visarga is preceded by a and followed by h other than akara, short vowel, then that visarga, that is nothing but repa, is replaced by yakara. Once it is replaced as yakara, the yakara lopa will happen optionally according to the special optional rule what we saw in the achandi. You have to recall that. Padanta yakara vakara preceded by avarna followed by ash will become lopaha. So two rupam forms will be there. Understand? Then the last one also same. Visarga preceded by here akara, long vowel, followed by ash. Here also that visarga. Visarga means repa. Think it as a repa. Will be replaced by yakara. Then the yakara becomes lopaha optionally. You have to connect with again that sandhi, achandhi rule, what we have saw, we seen. Then the final category, now the last one. If visarga is followed by ash and preceded by any letter other than what mentioned above, then repa has to be considered in the place of visarga. In fact, repa alone is there. There is no visarga, because when you are doing sandhi, there is visarga. Visarga will come only when it is avasana. When it is followed by other than kar letter and not avasana, what will be there? Repa alone will be there. Understand? Recall. Repa alone will be there. What will happen to that repa? Nothing happens. If none of the above, A, B, C, D doesn't fulfill, none of the conditions satisfies, then repa alone will be there. That's why I said you have to consider repa in the place of visarga. Always it is repa only. Okay. Becomes visarga only when followed by kar or avasana. When you are doing sandhi, there is no avasana. There is no pause when you are doing sandhi. And only when kar letter is there, then repa will become visarga. If kar letter already we have seen, that is covered. Now, vowels and soft consonants. Therefore, repa alone will be there. Therefore, really speaking, these are not visarga. These are repa only. Okay, there's a repa only. When you're doing sandhi, you have to take one step back. Visarga will come in the place of repa. But when you're doing sandhi, one step back. What was in the place of visarga? Repa. That alone you have to consider. So repa undergoing all these changes, depending on what precedes and what follows. If none of the four, A, B, C, D, the four conditions are fulfilled, the fifth one, it falls into general category, fifth one, the repa alone is there. Therefore, there is no special rule. Repa is there. Then you just do the mail down. Okay, this is what we saw so far. Do you remember, all of you, up to this?
Yes. Yes, Guruji.
Okay, shall I proceed further?
Yes.
Okay. Because if you don't understand this, if you proceed further, you won't understand anything. So you have to know it, put this very clearly. I'll give homework later. Okay, having covered, after covering this, then I'll give you homework. Then we are going to do a lot of homework. We are going to do in the class, and we'll give homework also. You can try. So these examples we saw, Ramaha plus Api, Visarga preceded by, I keep saying this, you have to register in your mind. Visarga preceded by A, followed by A. Visarga will be replaced by Ukara. So Ramaha plus Api, Visarga preceded by A and followed by A, Visarga replaced by Ukara. And Rama plus U, Gunasandhi will happen. You get Ramo Api and then Ramo P, that is by Purvarupa Sandhi. Achandi. Achandi rules should be with your fingertips, you must be knowing it. Ramo P. Similarly, Rama plus Agachyata. Ramo Agachyata, another example. Then this we have seen. Then Visarga preceded by A and followed by Hash. Visarga will be replaced by Ukara. Then Guna happens. Rama plus Ramaha plus Gachyati becomes Ramo Gachyati. That also we have seen. Visarga preceded by A and followed by Ach, other than short vowel. Then what happens? Visarga will be replaced by Yakara and Yakara becomes Lopaha. Optionally, you have to connect to the previous. Becomes Lopaha optionally if it is Padanta Yakara. Okay, that you have to. If it is Padanta, the Yakara, if it is Padanta, Padanta Yakara, not any Yakara. If it is Padanta, if it is at the end of Padam. Padam is P-A-D-A-M. I can type in Sanskrit later. Padam. That is important. Padanta Yakara, the condition. Padanta Yakara becomes Ropa. That you have to remember. So therefore, here if you see. Therefore here. Ramaha plus Agachati. Example. Visarga preceded by A and followed by A, followed by vowel. What vowel? Dirga Akara, other than short vowel. If it is short vowel, Visarga will be replaced by Ukara. Now long vowel. Therefore, Visarga will be replaced by Yakara. Now Ramai comes. Ramai is also a Padam only. If Ramaha is a Padam, Ramai is also going to be a Padam only. So Padanta Yakara. Preceded by A. Makara plus A is there. Preceded by Avarna. Followed by Ash letter. Therefore, this Yakara becomes Lopaha. So, Rama Agachati. Or you can just do the meaning Ramaya Agachati. That is option number one. Or option number two, Rama Agachati. Two forms possible. So, Rama Agachati is another form. Because Yakara Lopaha is optional. If you don't do Lopaha, you get Ramaya Agachati. If you do Lopa, then you get Rama Agachati. After doing Lopa, don't do Sandhi again. If you try to do, then Yakara will pop up and say, I'm there. You cannot do Sandhi. Those things we have seen. So, you know. So, this is the general form you will see in all the Sandhi. In the text and all, you will see Visarga will not be there. And Visarga is not there. Don't think it is a typo. It has gone. It has disappeared by this. Okay, then Visarga preceded by Akara, Dirga Vogal, Dirga Akara, and followed by Ash, followed by any vowel or any soft consonant. Then what will happen? The same thing.
Charanji, yes. With Rama Agachati, when there is it is in Lopa, again, near that, you've written with the Avagrahas, right, Charanji?
Yes.
That is not, so that is not a joint thing or anything. It is,
Avagraha to show that it is one avagraha means akara. Agachati, it is to show that I have given like this. It is not sandhi, right?
Okay,
it is not sandhi.
Okay,
even if I write like this, Rama Agachati, it is not sandhi, You have to separate and understand. Rama Agachati.
Okay, thank you,
Shanti. So here also, the next one, we'll copy paste this condition. That is, Nisarga preceded by A and followed by Ash. Then this Nisarga will be replaced by Yakara, and Yakara Lopa optionally happens if it is at the end of the Padam. Here you have to note, if hush letter follows, hush letter is soft consonant, then Yakara Lopa always happens. There is no optionality. That is why note is given. See, Visarga is replaced by Yakara. Then when it is preceded by A, followed by Ash. And within Ash letter, Ash, we have vowels and soft consonants. If soft consonants follow, then Yakara Lopaha must happen. If vowels follow, then Yakara Lopaha is optional. So that's why Yakara Lopaha optionally, Yakara becomes Lopaha optionally at the end of the Padam. Then note I have written here, if Ash follows, it must happen. So if soft consonants follow only one form will be there. If vowels follow, two forms will be there. You see the example. Balaha plus Atra. Visarga preceded by A. Bala, that Bala, Akara is there. Followed by the vowel A. Any vowel. Okay. Any vowel can follow. Because Ash letter. We said Ash letter. Ash plus Hash. Here what happens, Visarga? It is replaced by Yakara. Now Padanta Yakara. Because Balaha is Padam. Bala is also a Padam. So Balai plus Atra. You can just do Melanam. Get the form. Bala Yatra. That is one form. Another form is this Yakara can become Lopaha optionally. Therefore, Bala Atra. Why it can become Lopaha optionally? Because followed by the vowel, therefore optional. If it is followed by a consonant, soft consonant, then Ekara Lopaha must happen. Only one form will be there. At that example, we will see.
Even this we can write using Avagraha, Sharanji? Bala Atra?
Why not? You can write.
Okay.
You can write like this. Bala Atra.
Thank you.
So you have to know here, it is Balaha Atra. Or depending on the context, it could be a Bala, girl, one girl. Or Balaha, girls or boys. That depends on the context. If you say Balaha Atra, okay. Balaha Atra also Balatra. Bala Atra also Balatra. So it depends on the context. And if it is Balaha, it can mean boys or girls. If it is Bala, it has to be only one girl. So all the possibilities are there. So depending on context, you have to know what it is. So that context also makes very important. Sandhi karya depends on the one is the general rule. The context wise, whether what the shabda is, that padam is, that depends on the context. Whether it is Balaha or Balaha and all. Okay, then next one. Lataha plus Edhante. Here Visarga preceded by A and followed by the vowel A. So what will happen to Visarga replaced by Yakara? And they just do Melanam. Lataha Edhante. This is one form. Or Lataha plus Edhante. Replace Visarga by Yakara optionally. Sorry, replacement is not optional. Yakara must come. Then Yakara Lopaha can happen optionally. Therefore, Lata Edante. After that, don't do Gunasandhi. A plus A is there. Don't do Gunasandhi. Try to Gunasandhi, the Lopa will pop up. Lopaha means you have to understand that which is not available for your darshanam, not available for your sight, not available for your hearing, but it is there. I will say Lata Edante. Edhante is gross. Bhagavachana. Edhate, edete, edante. Atmanipadi. What grows? Lataha edante. It is not Lata edante. It can't be ekabachana. Lataha, Bhagavachana. Lata, late, lataha. So it is Bhagavachana. So, therefore, Lataha edante. So further, if you do Gunasandhi, it's a problem. You then then the Lataha will not be a Lataha anymore. It will not be Bhagavachana Padam anymore. Therefore, Gunasandhi cannot happen. Whenever Lopa is there, understand, Lopa means that it's not available for your perception. It is there. So further Sandhi denied. Is it clear up to this?
Yes, Ji.
All of you.
Yes, Ji.
Please unmute your mic, yes, and respond.
Ji. Yes, Ji.
Yes, Guruji.
Okay, shall we proceed further? Ji. Yes.
Yes, Guruji. If it is soft consonant, what you told that Yakara will be Lopaha only.
Yakara will be Lopaha only. That example.
Example for that.
I have not given, I'll give an example. I have not written, I'll write now. Okay. If it's a soft consonant, then Ekara Lopaha must happen. Okay. This is number 3. I'll give one example. This is number 3. And there is no option. No option. Example. Lataha. Same example I'm taking. Rohanti. If you take. Lataha. Rohanti. Here Lataha. Sarga preceded by A. Followed by H letter. Soft consonant. Rohanti. So replace it that by Yakara, then this Yakara Lopaha must happen. So we cannot retain Yakara. So what will happen? Lata Rohanti. Only one form. That's what it says. It is. Okay. Right? Now the next one. Next one is general category. So here when I say here it is, when I say Visarga means Visarga one step back. Always it is Repa only. You have to remember. Even though I have written Visarga, Visarga, even in books also it is written Visarga. But really speaking, it is not Visarga, it is Repa. But I have explained in the last class, you have to recall. So it is not really Visarga. Visarga has to be born, right? Repa alone is there. Visarga will born only when followed by Avasana. In Sandhi, Avasana is ruled out. Not the Avasana is there, and Vaisandhi can happen. Vaisandhi will happen. So followed by Kar letter only, Visarga will be there. If Kar letter not there, then Repa alone will be there. Therefore, all the way the change is happening only to the Repa. Repa alone is replaced by Ukara. Repa alone is replaced by Yakara. Okay. So Repa alone is there all the way. Now, any of the above four means preceded by A, followed by A, preceded by A, followed by Ash, preceded by A, followed by Ash. All those things are covered. Anything other than that. You have to see that Repa is there in the place of Visarga. Okay. So other than that, we are going to see what will happen. When Visarga is followed by Ash and preceded by any letter other than A or A, then Repa has to be considered in the place of Visarga. In fact, you don't have to consider. It is Repa alone. That's what I explained now. So, Guruhu Atati, if you take this, Guruhu, the Visarga has, okay, let me ask, Visarga has come in the place of?
Sakara.
So,
Visarga,
okay, if you do step by step, Visarga has come in the place of Repa. Repa is nothing but Ru. The Ru has come in the place of? Sakara.
Sakara.
Padanta Sakara. So, that Repa now, it will become Visarga when at the end, Avasana. If you say Guru Hu, stop there, pause. Then Visarga will be there. Now we are going to do Sandhi. What is Sandhi? Okay, let me ask a simple question. What is Sandhi? Definition of Sandhi.
Close proximity. Close proximity.
Close proximity of letters. And the resultant change happening because of the close proximity. Both are called Sandhi. Sandhi. Parasannikarsha Sanhita. Atishayena Varnanam Sannidhi. That is called Sanhita, Sandhihi. Sanhita, technical word. And the Sandhi Karyam also is called Sandhi. Now, in the Sandhi, there is no Avasana, there is no pause. and followed by kar letter only will be become visarga. Therefore, what is here is only repa. So gurur atati, that is what is really there. Now gurur atati is there. That's why I said you have to consider repa in the place of visarga. One step back. This is what I mean. That now repa plus a will become just melanam. There is no sandhi. In fact, here there is no sandhi. Just melanam. Guruhu plus atati is equal to guru ratati. Is it clear?
Yes, ji.
Visarga preceded by what letter? Ukara. Other than a or a. Number one. See, when visarga is preceded by any letter other than a or a, we just apply this rule. Simple. Followed by not kar letter, other than kar letter. When followed by other than kar letter, that is vowels or soft consonants, preceded by other than avarna, akara or akara. Apply this. Just do the melanam. Consider the repa to be there in the place of visarga and just do melanam. Understand? Next one. Arihi plus ichchati. So, visarga preceded by e and followed by e. So, no problem. Followed by ash letter. Hari ichchati. Just join. In the place of visarga, repa is there. So, ari ichchati. Then, another example. So, when you do sandhi, we have to see what precedes, what succeeds. When preceding letter is other than avarna, followed by ash letter, just do the melanam. Melanam, how do? You have to consider repa in the place of visarga and do melanam. Mayu kaihi aham. Mayu kair plus aham. Mayu kai raham iti. Okay. Understand up to this? This topic is over. So changes happening to visarga is completed. If you have doubt, any doubts, please clarify now itself so that we can proceed. Shall we proceed further?
Yes, Guruji.
Now this changes happening to Saha and Yesha. What is Saha? Tatshabda Pratamavibhakti Ekavachanam, right? Yeshaha is Etat Shabda Pratamavibhakti Ekavachanam. So we are talking particularly about the word, the Saha and Yeshaha. Now let me ask you. Type here. Saha Agachati or Saha Agachati. Suppose if I say, what sandhi you will do? Saha
Visarga preceded by
Yakara.
Yakara. Think. Okay, please think. Visarga preceded by A, followed.
Preceded. Sorry.
Visarga preceded by A, followed by A. Both you have to see.
Ukara.
Ukara will come. Therefore, what will happen? Saha will become.
So gachat.
Okay. Saha. Gachati. Yoriji, there is some noise at your hand. Please make sure that there is no noise. Saha gachati. What is sandhi here?
I think no sandhi, melanam only, Guruji, with repa.
With repa, how can you melanam followed by consonant, right?
No, sorry. Guru atati is pa is there, rohanti.
Visarga preceded by ha, followed by?
Lataha rohanti. Lopa happens. It is like lata rohanti example. Lataha rohanti.
Lopa happens. Visarga preceded by what letter?
Akara.
Visarga preceded by, okay. Not followed.
Akara.
Preceded. Akara. Not ashi letter. Followed by what letter?
Ash letter, G.
Followed by ash letter.
Ash letter.
So, what will happen to Visarga now?
Lopa happens. It it turns to
have lopa? We have not seen lopa. No, we have not seen lopa like that. We do like that rule. We have not seen at all. Vistarga preceded by a, followed by hash. Ukara will.
Ukara.
Vistarga will not become yakara. How can it become yakara? You have to check the rule. What we have seen. Visarga preceded by a, followed by a. Visarga preceded by a, followed by hash will be replaced by ukara only. How it is yakara? When yakara will come? When visarga preceded by a, followed by ash, other than a. Visarga preceded by a, followed by ash, then only yakara will come. The four points, four rules you have to remember, right? So you have to check. So visarga will not be replaced by yakara. It is the rule what we know, visarga will be replaced by ukara. Therefore, what you have?
So akara. Akara plus ukara, it becomes
sokachati.
Guna will happen, sokachati you get, right?
Yes, G.
So, now the rule what we are going to say, see is, it is not going to be so. So is not going to be so. Why? This is specifically for the word saha. If saha is a word, precedes, if saha is a word, saha means pratama vibhakti ekavacham, that visarga is saha. Similarly, yeshaga is there. What happens there? There visarga lopa happens. Just all. Visarga lopa happens. Not that will become yakara and lopa and all. Visarga lopa. Just it is dropped. That is the rule we are going to see now. It's a new rule. Change happening to visarga of sakara means saha and yeshaha. Saha. Saha is tatshabda pratama vibhakti ekavachanam. Yeshaha etatshabda pratama vibhakti ekavachanam. And followed by, when does it happen? Followed by al. What is that al? Al is accepting a. Al means what? All the letters, right? What is al? It covers all the...
Ikara to...
It covers all the letters.
All the letters.
Al covers all the letters. First of all, al is all the letters. Al means vowels and consonants of the language. Everything is covered by Al. Starting from IE1 up to the last sutra, Hal, right? 14th sutra. All the letters are covered. Now I say excepting A. It means Akara is removed. So remove short vowel A. It means long vowel is there. Right? Understand?
Yeah.
So removing short A. A will be there, E will be there, U will be there, R will be there, L, A, O, I, O, all the other letters will be there. Akara must not be there. Understand? That is the condition. You have to understand the condition clearly. Remember, understand and remember. Okay. So, if that is a condition, what happens to Visarga of Saha and Yeshaga? It is just dropped. When followed by any letter, excepting short A, the visarga of saha and yesha is dropped. Visarga of saha and yesha is dropped. Example, you can see. The dropping of visarga is achieved by two separate rules, even though the result of application of two distinct rules is same. Anyway, that we will see later. Dropping of, you will see now. I'll explain the nun and note, you will understand. What is al? Al is equal to h plus al. We know this, vowels and consonants. When followed by h, what follows h? What follows this? Followed by h means h follows what? That yesha saha, that's what the topic is. Remember it. Okay. We're talking only about the two words, saha and yesha. Saha and yesha means the visarga of saha, the visarga of yeshaha, the two particular words we are dealing with now. For that one rule is that, you see, for the two words, one rule is that. What is that? When followed by ach, ach is a part of ash letter. Anyway, that we know. So, followed by ach, excepting akara, excepting short vowel. The visarga of saha, and yeshaha is replaced by yakara and it becomes lopaha optionally. This is not a rule, really speaking. This is not a rule means this is not a new rule, really speaking. This rule is already covered.
Yep.
How it is covered, if you ask? Visarga for this saha and eshaha is preceded by what letter? You have to follow step by step. Akara, right? Now, followed by any letter other than a. Followed by any letter other than short vowel. Then what will happen to visarga?
Dropped.
Huh? See the four things what we have seen. You have to remember the four points, the four rules.
Visarga,
yakara will come.
But yakara lopa also happens.
That we'll see later. First you have to say yakara. You have to remember the four. Nobody say remembers, I think, this. All the notes already been sent. When I ask this, the fourth thing, you have to remember this. Visarga preceded by a and followed by the H letter, I said, other than a. What category is that? A, B, C, D.
Number four.
Every time I cannot show you this. So you have to remember this. You have to remember this four. So visarga preceded by a, followed by H, excepting a, I am saying.
C.
Yakara.
Therefore, yakara will come. You have to say it. You have to remember this. Okay, this is very important. Otherwise, if you say something, then I get confused whether I taught you properly or not. So, visarga is replaced. That visarga is replaced by yakara. Then yakara will become lopaha optionally, right? Examples, you see. It's not a new example. Not a new rule. Examples may be new, but not a new rule. Already we have seen this. Like example, you see. Saha agachati. What happens here? Saha agachati.
Yakara.
Here, visarga preceded by a, followed by a. What will happen? Visarga is replaced by yakara. Now, this option number one, yakara, you can retain it and just do the melanam. Saya agachati. Then, option number two, there, yakara lopa happens. So, when yakara lopa happens, sa agachati, that is the form you get. This is not something new. Already we have seen. Lata plus edante and all we saw. Lata, roganti, right? The same example. Can you follow what I'm saying?
Yes,
sir. Same rule. I'm not teaching any new rule. Instead of lataha, ramaha, I'm saying saha. That's all. Followed by ash letter other than short verbal. Right? Whether it is, even if it's lataha agachanti, what will it be there? Lata agachanti. Balaha agachati. What will be there? Bala agachati. The same thing, Bala. Right? I'm not teaching any new rule. Whatever we have seen, I'm saying. This is for saha. Then what is the new rule you're talking about, if you ask? That is going to come now. So, when followed by a, visarga will be replaced by ukara. Okay. When followed by short vowel, I said, when followed by ach, other than short vowel, I said. Now, if followed by akara, what will happen to visarga? You may ask, what will happen to visarga? Visarga of saha and yeshaha, if it is followed by short vowel.
Will be replaced by ukara.
It will be replaced by ukara. Fall in the general category, right? And A, category number A. Visarga preceded by a, followed by a. You have to remember the four points. Go back here and see again. Visarga preceded by a and followed by a. Which one will come? Which category is that? A, B, C, D?
A.
So, saha atati. Now you tell me. Saha atati. What is the sandhi? What will happen? Saha atati. He roams. Roams
so
around.
So atati.
You can do pararupa, adhe, pururupa sandhi. You can say sotati, right? so atati or so tati. Saha aham. What is the sandhi? Saha aham.
Soham.
Soham.
Soham. Soham is a mantra. Soham, soham. Okay. Now, saha agachati already we have seen. So, now you see. If visarga for saha and eshaha, saha and eshaha, the shabda, visarga is preceded by a only, not any other letter. Right? For saha and eshaha, the two particular padams, visarga is preceded by short vowel only. Okay. When followed by a, then visarga will be replaced by ukara. That is no special rule. When followed by ach, other than a, visarga will be replaced by yakara. Yakara lopa will happen optionally, right? Is it clear? I'm talking about only for saha and eshaha.
Yes.
Now, what is left out here is visarga, because you have to see only, consider only the three categories. Here you have to consider only three categories. Why not a fourth category for this saha and eshaha?
Because it's not a long vowel.
Long vowel not there, simple. Therefore, don't consider that. Only there's three, right? So, if only three are there, the two possibilities already we have covered. One is replaced by ukara, other one is replaced by yakara. Yakara lopa happens. Now, what is left out? It's a difficult question.
Second case,
what does it say? Visarga followed by soft consonants. Ash. So, there what happens? There only the new rules come. New rule for this eshaha and saha. Visarga preceded by a and followed by hush. Right? So, that now only I am going to introduce that rule. So far, I have made you recall what you have seen. So, some example I have given. Okay, anyway, that you can go through that. Now, a new rule. When followed by, I am saying hal. What is hal and what is hush?
Hal is all consonants. Hush is without syllables.
Hush is?
Soft consonants,
right? Mm. Somebody said sibilance. I don't know why sibilance came here.
I said it.
Sibilance, where is sibilance here? Only hakara is the only sibilant, right? So, hush is soft consonant, al is all the consonant. Now, when followed by any consonant, I say, then what happened to visarga of eshaha and saha? It is just dropped. No changes happening. Visarga is still lopaka bhavati. Example, you see. Saha gachati. Visarga preceded by a, followed by hal. And it happens to be a soft consonant. No problem, maybe, doesn't matter. It is followed by a consonant. That's all. Then what happened to visarga? Drop it. Saha gachati. Understand? Similarly, eshaha. Ramaha, visarga preceded by a, that is eshaha, followed by hal, drop it, visarga, esha ramaha, right? So, when followed by, therefore the rule is, the new rule is, what we are learning, for this saha and eshaha, when it is followed by a word beginning with a consonant, the visarga of these words are dropped. That's the rule. Is it clear now?
Yes, Guruji.
Only when followed by hal. If it is followed by vowel, apply the rule, whatever we have seen, general rule. If it is followed by among the vowel, akara, apply the rule, ukara. Ukara will come in the place of visarga. That is why you get soham. Right? Is it clear? You have to combine everything and understand. This is particularly only when followed by hal for these two words, saha and eshaha, visarga is dropped. okay. So this is very simple, not difficult rule. Visarga preceded by ach. Apply the previous rule, whatever you have learned. Depending on what the what the succeeding letters is. Visarga followed by, if it is ach letter, then if akara is there, ukara will come. Other than akara is there, ekara will come. Ekara is lopaha bhavati, all those things you know. Now if it is followed by hal, visarga is just drop. That's all. This is a rule. Now, we will show you the example. Now, you have to answer. I myself have given the answer. Actually, I should not have given. I did for some class. Anyway, I'll give you more homework. We are going to do putraha plus dhap. So, whatever the rules we have studied, you remember now. Okay, let me quickly summarize. Padanta sakara becomes ru, ru becomes visarga, repa, ru is nothing but repa, repa becomes visarga at yavasana or followed by kar letter, number one. When followed by kar letter, repa will become visarga. And when followed by, again, the kar letter, visarga will become sakara, depending on what the kar letter is. Exceptions are there. Then sakara undergoes changes, again, depending on what letter follows, stuttam, ashtuttam. This is done. Now this visarga, this repa when followed by, when repa when followed by h, what will happen to that? Then in that case, you have to see repa preceded by what, followed by what. Repa, I mean visarga, okay? I'm saying specifically repa. Make you understand that repa is in the place of visarga. Repa when preceded by a and followed by a, ukara will be the adesha. When repa is preceded by a and followed by hash, ukara is the adesha. Repa when preceded by a and followed by h, other than short vowel, yakara will be the adesha. Repa when preceded by a and followed by hash letter, yakara will be the adesha. Yakara se lopaha happens optionally. If it is specifically for eshaha and saha, that visarga will become lopaha when followed by hal. This is a quick summary of whatever we have seen so far. With this in mind, you do this example. Putraha plus Davati. What Sandhi is here?
Gunasandhi.
Not immediately Gunasandhi. Okay, where is Gunasandhi?
Ukara. Padanta.
First it will become Ukara and then Apasu, so Gunasandhi.
That you have to say, yes. Visarga, you have to say completely. Visarga preceded by A, followed by Hash. Visarga will be replaced by Ukara. Then A plus Su will become Guna. Then Putro Davati. Those steps you have to write it. I'm just given the answer here. Putraha Davati is equal to Putro Davati. Okay, you type your name in the chat box. I will ask individually. Then only I'll come to know. Yeah. Please type your name in the chat box. I think you are afraid to type their name in the chat box. Most of them, they don't type anyway. Jyotiji, second one, please do. Taha Gacchanti. You have to tell the rule. Say what happens, how it happens. Jyoti, you can unmute your mic.
Yes, Guruji. Visarga, taha visarga, that is repa preceded by long vowel a, followed by a soft consonant. Hmm. So visarga is replaced by yakara, which is padanta yakara, so becomes low. So tai gacchante becomes ta gacchante.
Very good. That's what it is. You said it correctly. Girijaji, next one.
Yes, Guruji. Krishnaha Yeti. Visarga preceded by Akara, Hraswakara, followed by Ash letter. That means the first rule number A plus Ash. Second rule applies.
What
that
is it? Means,
in the place of Visarga, Yakara comes. A, Krishna. Na, ya, yeti, Krishna yeti.
Krishna yeti.
Krishna Veti.
Okay.
Yep.
That is one form.
Yep.
Other form is
Krishna Veti. Other form.
Yakara Lopaha happens, right? That's important.
Yakara Lopaha.
Joining sandhi is one thing. Splitting the sandhi is important. Joining sandhi is easy. Now okay. we are going to see later. Splitting the sandhi. I'll give you the form Krishna Yeti. You have to find out Krishna Yeti. The real challenge is there only. That is what you do in the when you read a text, Gita Upanishad and all. Splitting the sandhi and understanding what it is. Splitting is important. Joining is, you know the rule, you can join also. If that is difficult, you have to work on that. Splitting is more challenging. Okay, Krishna Yeti, if I give, you have to say Krishna Yeti. What would have happened? The reverse thing you have to do.
Okay.
Next person, Pramilaji. Janaha plus Abhitaha.
Janaha plus Abhitaha. Akara plus.
No, there is no Akara plus Repa. Not like that. Repa preceded by Ya. That is the right way to tell.
Okay.
Otherwise, Repa, it becomes an equation. That is not the equation.
Repa preceded by A, Akara, followed by Rasva A.
Yes. Yes, Pramilaji, what happened? Hello? Okay.
Two. O.
So. I think you have muted your mic.
Ji, not muted, Ji.
No.
Phone call came.
Okay.
Akara. Akara.
Okay. Another Ji, please do.
Preceded by Akara.
Hmm.
Followed by Rasva A. Repa becomes Yakara and it gets Lopaha. So it is Jana Abhitaha or Jana or it is Jana Abhitaha.
Yes. Next person. Anuradhaji.
Okay. Janaha. Plus Vasati, that is Akara preceded by, Repa preceded by Akara, the Rasva, followed by Hash. So then the Padanta Repa becomes U and Guna happens and so we get Jano Vasati.
Yes. Surendraji, next one. Surendra Ji, unmute your mic.
Yeah. Manaha Chanchalam. Mana A plus Visarga plus Chai. Chai is a kar letter, no?
Na A plus Visarga and all. When Visarga is. You don't have to say A plus Visarga. It's not an equation. That understanding is there, it will lead to problem. There's no equation here. Visarga preceded by what, followed by what? Yes.
Visarga preceded by A, followed by kar letter.
Followed by kar letter. Therefore, we don't have to worry about what the preceding letter, not required. If the kar letter follows, you don't have to worry about what letter precedes. That's what I said, right? The beginning.
Yes, Guruji.
Then why do you worry about the preceding letter? Visarga followed by kar. That is what I expect you to say first. I don't bother about what letter precedes because it is not going to make any contribute any for any change here. Then what happens after that?
If they can Visarga becomes Sakara.
Katam. How? Tell me the rule.
Sakara becomes Sakara, then. Shuddha Sandhi will come.
First, you have to tell me how Sakara comes, then only Shuddha Sandhi. Visarga will become sakara au. Anybody?
Visarga becomes ru. Ru becomes sakara.
Visarga has come.
Padanta sakara.
Okay. No, visarga has come. You said visarga is there. Visarga will become now sakara. Tell me how.
Followed by
car letter. Simple. That's what you say. Followed by car letter. Visarga comes because of car letter. And visarga will become sakara because of car letter. All the things because of the car letter. Then only chuttam happens. Surendra ji, you have to work on this. Okay. Next person, Lata ji.
Okay. Ramaha plus Chatraha. Here also the visarga followed by car letter. It will be replaced by Sakara and Ramas plus Chatra is Ramas Chatra.
Sandhi. Chutta Sandhi. Rajaji, next one.
Esha plus Arya, so that becomes Esha Arya. So this is Repa preceded by Akara, followed by Ash letter. It's followed by Ash letter, the other than A. So this will be then the visarga will be replaced by akara.
No. Mm-hmm. Okay, okay. Yeah, yeah. Is you right? Visarga in this case will be replaced by akara. Yes, you're right. Please still continue. Yes.
Yeah. Then right.
It is then, Arya.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Then optionally it will disappear. So it will become Esha Arya.
Yes, good. Very good. Arya is a vowel, not a consonant. If it is consonant, visarga is dropped. If it is a verbal, then it is replaced by yakara. Yakara becomes lopaha optionally, therefore esha adhya. That is correct.
Now, here we don't want to say for saka, saha and esha, it is totally different, optional like that. We don't want to say here.
Here it comes under general category. Only when followed by hal, visarga is dropped. That's what I said. Following letter, what letter? It's a verbal letter. You have to see it is a verbal. Only when it's a hal, soft the consonant is there, then only it is dropped. Otherwise, no.
Okay.
The next one is a good example for that. Rajaji, do that also.
Yeah. So this is Saha plus Jayati. So this is again Repa preceded by A, followed by this is Hush letter, Guruji.
Yes.
So since we have a special rule for Saha and Yeshaha, will be dropped when it is followed by hal.
Yes. Therefore, between these two, it looks as though both have the same rule, but not. The first one, yakara comes and yakara is dropped optionally. The second one, visarga itself is dropped. That is the difference, right?
Correct. The first one, it is followed by ach later.
Yes.
But then we have a special rule for yakara and vakara. So that rule, because of that, it's getting dropped.
Yes. Ramila ji, understand the difference between the two. So don't mix up these two. Saha jayate, sa jayate. Because of the special rule, followed by hal. Next one.
Ji, saha eshaha. So if it is followed by each letter.
Not each letter at all. Followed by hal, visarga is dropped. That is the rule. Other than that, apply the other rules. Common rules.
Other than the same previous visarga.
Previous. Then you have to see visarga preceded by A, followed by A, whatever is there, you do it.
Okay.
The next one, Jyotiji.
So, Guruji, next two will be the same, no? Saha, Eva, and Eshaha, Krodhaha. So, Saha, it is followed by a vowel.
Yes.
So, it becomes. So yakara, which is dropped, and eshaha krodha, it is followed.
That's okay.
By
slowly, one by one. First is saha eva, you do it. Yes.
Saha plus eva, visarga followed by vowel, so becomes yakara, which is dropped.
After that, can you do sandhi?
No, if it is lopa, further sandhi is not possible when it is lopa.
Okay. Now the second one. Yes.
So, eshaha krodhaha, again, visarga followed by a consonant, a khar letter. So, it is the general
consonant.
Rule that the visarga is...
consonant you can say, not curl letter, not required, followed by consonant, because the rule
followed by consonant. So there's a general rule that the visarga is dropped.
Visarga is dropped. Now visarga, okay, if you say it, it's a curl letter, you know what happens? Eshaha krodaha
artha visarga,
that will come, right? That is why I specifically said don't say it as a curl letter. If you say curl letter, then what you will do is you will think about applying the artha visarga, because ka kha pa pa we have seen. So yes, visarga will be replaced by artha visarga. That is not the case here. Even though it's a curl letter, by when you look upon this as a consonant, when you say it as a hal, then you will bring in the new rule. What the new rule means, the rule what we have studied.
Yes, yes, Guruji.
That's why I specifically ask you to use the word hal, consonant.
Yes, okay. Guruji.
Now, therefore, this is what is the relationship between this new rule, that is the rule Eshaha Saha Visarga is dropped followed by consonant, and the Visarga followed by Kha Kha. What is the connection between these two rules?
So that Kha Kha, that Artha Visarga rule is not
the word Eshaha, Guruji.
Huh?
The word Padam Eshaha itself is the new rule.
What is the connection I'm asking? Okay, connection. Visarga followed by ka or kha will be replaced by artha visarga. It is a general rule. Okay. Eshaha krodaha is overrules that. Therefore, this is apavada, exception. Right? That's what I want you to say. So this overrules that. This rule overrules the rule that is visarga followed by the kar letter.
Okay.
The rules are connected in terms of utsarga apavada. General rule, exception. General exception. General exception. That is how we discovered.
Yeah.
So, therefore, when you connect with the kar letter, you have to say that kar letter is that artha visarga rule is overruled by this rule. So, this is applied. Visarga still open.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. Now you can do Girjaji.
Ataha. Ataha. Visarga is followed by short hraswa a. That means it will be followed, it will be replaced by u.
Yes.
Atho.
Guna happens. You have to say guna happen, and then
guna happens atho ataha.
And then pururupa sandhi.
Pururupa sandhi. Yep.
All this you have to say. Otherwise,
Guruji, yeah.
You have to say visarga is. See, you have to say in this way. Visarga preceded. You have to can follow the very word that I say. Visarga preceded by a, followed by a. Visarga is replaced by ukara. Then a plus u guna will happen. Then o plus a. Pururupa sandhi will happen. Everything is should be there.
Okay, Guruji.
Next one, Pramilaji.
Shat plus saranti.
Yes.
It is chutva. It is shatva sandhi.
There is no shatva sandhi at all. Shtutva only is there. Shtutvam or shtutvam?
Shtutvam. It is shtutvam, shtutva sandhi, ji.
If it is shtutva sandhi, what should have happened and what is there in the screen? The answer. Hello?
Ji?
Yeah. What sandhi is it? If it is stutta sandhi, okay, if you take the stutta sandhi, what will happen now? Tell me.
Ji, there should be repa. There is no repa.
Why repa should be there? We are not, repa should be there everywhere. Why repa should be there? If it is stutta sandhi, where repa is? Why are you getting mixing up with repa? Repa itself is, repa becomes sakara and all that is different. Right? This is a totally different thing. You are connecting two distinct things, two different things. Why? What's the confusion? Shat plus Saranti, where is Repa? Shat is a Padam. Saranti is also a Padam. Not every Padam must have Repa. Palam is there. Palam, does it have Repa? Palam Pale Palani, Palam Pale Palani. Where is Repa in Palam? It's a Padam. Palani is also a Padam. Pale is also a Padam. Even Ramashabda, Rame is there. It's a Padam. Where is Repa? Right? Shat is a Padam. Then Saranti is another Padam. Both are joining. Then Sandhi between the two letters happen. What Sandhi is that? You said correctly only. Further you say?
Shutva Sandhi.
Yeah. Shutva Sandhi means what will happen? What will happen to what?
Ji, Takara when followed by
Takara is here in the Uttara Padam, the last letter, and sorry, in the Purva Padam, and in the Uttara Padam, what is the last letter?
Sakara.
That's what you have to see. Then between Takara and Sakara, there is a Melanam. Sorry, that is a the Sandhi, the combination. So what Sandhi is that? Anybody?
Shakara.
So this is Shrutva Sandhi, Guruji.
So what will happen to then?
So there is an exception. So when the Tavarga comes at the end of a Padam, that is when Stu is preceded by Tavarga.
Very good.
At the end of a Padam, then the Shrutvam will not happen. This is the exception rule. So only the Melanam will be up.
Why exactly? That's what it happens. So how do you say it now? Sakara in contact with Takara. Praminaji, that is all you have to see. Sakara in contact with Takara, Tavarga letter. Tavarga letter. And the Tavarga letter happens to be the end of the Padam. Generally, Sakara in contact with Tavarga letter. Whether it is preceding contact or succeeding contact, Shtuttam will happen. But here, the Sakara in contact with Tavarga letter, Takara here, at the end of the Padam, then Shtutva Sandhi will not apply. Therefore, the exception is, it remains as it is. Shat Saranti.
Melanam will
happen. You have to study, work on the homework. We have to go, please go through the previous recording. Okay, then next one, Anuradhaji. Vrikshaha plus Chadaniyaha.
Here, Visarga is followed by Khar letter. So, it is replaced by, it will become Sakara. Then Shutvam happens. We get Vrikshas Chadaniyaha.
Good. That's it, simple. Next one, Surendraji.
Kripanaha Jivanti.
Yes. What happens here? Please do it quickly. Huh? Time not there. Hello?
Yeah. That. It's an us letter. No, we can't.
No, you tell me completely. Just don't say us letter, us letter.
Visarga preceded by Virgaha followed by us letter.
Okay, what happens then?
Then Yakara will come.
Okay, continue. Please can tell me complete. You have to tell very fluently. That when the rule is understood thoroughly, you have to tell it fluently, not bits and pieces. You have to work on this. Because we are dealing with the same thing for so many classes, so it should become very thorough now. Visarga preceded by A, followed by ashtata. Visarga will become visarga. Repa actually is there. Visarga, okay, let it be visarga, will be replaced by yakara. Then padanta yakara, preceded by avarna, followed by ashtata. Lopaga bhavati. That's what Krishna jivanti. This is what you are supposed to say. Okay, next person, Rajaji. That we will stop.
Yeah, so this is Atra plus Ita hai. So this is Guna Sandhi, Guruji. Atra Ita hai.
Simple, Guna Sandhi. A plus E, Guna. So we, all of you have to work. Okay, there's, we'll keep learning more and more. If you don't work on that, then difficult. We'll not understand what I'm going to teach further. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamadachyate Purnasya Purnamadhaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.
Dhaniwad Guruji.
Dhaniwad Guruji.
Dhaniwad.
धन्यवाद गुरुजी
हरि ओम जी
नमस्ते
हरि